Welcome to the BISP Solutions. So our today's topic is foreign subsidiary in statement of financial positions. Now we'll see what is foreign subsidiary. It's a foreign subsidiary company is any company where 50% or more of its equity shares are owned by a company that is incorporated in another foreign nation. That means foreign subsidiary is a business entity that is owned to a certain degree by another entity from foreign country. The company owning the subsidiary is called the holding company. For example, an Indian company Z invested his money in USA Y company. So the Y company has become the subsidiary company. There are two companies, Indian company, which is denoted as Z, and a foreign subsidiary, which is denoted as Y. This investment was done in USA dollars. Y company's all expenses and incomes, they are in USA dollars. But Indian company Z deals in Indian currency. So Y company, that which is our foreign subsidiary, its currency is USA dollar. And Indian company, which is Z, its currency in Indian currency, that is INR. Now, how will Indian Z company consolidate with Y USA subsidiary company? Now, because both the currencies are different, for solving this issue, IFRS have given some guidelines, that is International Financial Reporting Standards. We'll follow that. Now, first we see why we are consolidating foreign subsidiary. The essence of consolidating foreign subsidiary is that their financial statements are presented in different currency from that of their parent's presentation currency. So, before you start performing the consolidation procedures, you need to translate the subsidiary's financial statements to that parent's presentation currency. That means the currency in which the financial statements of parent are presented, that is our reporting currency, we need to translate the foreign subsidiary's financial statement into that currency. For that, you need the exchange rate. Okay, after converting, there will be some translation gain or loss. Or we can say it FCTR, that is foreign currency translation reserve. And it goes in the consolidated statement of OCI. There are some steps how to convert the foreign currency's financial statement into reporting currency financial statement. First, identify the reporting entity reporting currency. In our example, we have seen our reporting entity reporting currencies, that is India, it's INR, okay, Indian currency. Identify the reporting entity foreign entities, that is our foreign subsidiary Y. Determine the functional currency of each. Parent currency is Indian rupees and foreign subsidiary currency is USA dollars. As per our example, measure the foreign currency transactions. We'll see the foreign currency transactions. Translate the financial statements of the foreign entities. Yeah, we'll see the balance sheet and we'll translate the financial statement, that is assets and liabilities and equity, by using the foreign exchange rate. Okay, which rates to be used, I'll be telling you very soon. After that, evaluate whether CTA should be released. CTA is foreign currency cumulative translation adjustments, and when such amount should be released into the earnings, we'll see that. CTA arises from translating the foreign entity's financial statement into parent reporting currency. Okay, now here are some steps how to do the consolidation when you have the foreign subsidiary company. When subsidiary company is in foreign country, then the consolidation should be done by considering the following approach. First step, prepare the AOP in foreign currency. Okay, after that, convert the balance sheet of subsidiary including pre and post profits by applying AS 11 and Ind AS 21. These are the accounting standards 11 which you follow in India. Okay. So first we need to prepare the AOP in foreign currency so that we can derive the pre and post profits, include that pre and post profits in the balance sheet, and after that convert the balance sheet of the subsidiary into parent country's reporting currency. As per AS 11, subsidiary is treated as non-integral foreign operations. Following conversion rates are applied. See, all assets and liabilities which are there in the balance sheet, all will be converted using the closing exchange rate. Incomes and expenses will be converted using the actual rate or average rate. Share capital will be converted using the opening rate. any difference in the converted balance sheet of subsidiary, it is called the FCTR, that is foreign currency translation reserve, and that will be treated as a capital reserve. FCTR will be accounted for as post-acquisition profit or loss in the consolidated financial statements. FCTR will be shown under the consolidated P&L in respect of holding share and minority interest in respect of its share. Okay, we'll see this through an example. The balance sheet of X Limited, that is our parent company, and its subsidiary Y Incorporation, that is our foreign subsidiary, the balance sheet are given as at 31st March 2018. Okay. Separate balance sheet figures are given, like equity share capital, profits, loan, trade creditors, provision for tax, and in asset side, fixed assets are given, investment in Y is given 16 lakh, stock, debtors, and cash and bank equivalents are given of both the companies. Now, what we need to do are for, there is some additional information also. X Limited acquired 80% share in Y Incorporation on 1st July 2017, that is at the middle of the year. Okay, at that time, the profit and loss account showed a balance of $23,000. There are some abnormal items, that is gain or loss, in the books of subsidiary. Like on 1st June 2017, there was $3,000 abnormal gain. And on 4 September, there was abnormal loss of $15,000. Exchange rates are given. Opening rate is 30, closing rate 42, and average rate is given 36. So, our first step, prepare the AOP, that is analysis of profit of subsidiary company. These all steps I have shown you in the PPT slide. And I have written here also so that we can easily see the steps and do the process. First, prepare the AOP of the subsidiary. So first we'll prepare the AOP. Why we are preparing it? Because so that we can derive the profit which belongs to the pre and post. AOP profits total. See, here's a timeline diagram I have prepared. 1st April 2017 opening year and closing. Opening P&L was given 23. Closing P&L is given 40,000. Abnormal gain 1st June 2017 was abnormal gain of 3,000, and 4th September 17 there was an abnormal loss of 15,000. We have made the investment on 4th 7 2017 at 80%. Investment was done on 1st July, so before that, that is April, May, June, 3 months belong to the pre period, and after that 9 months belong to the post period. Okay, so while preparing this, we can see P&L, 40,000 is the closing and opening was 23,000. So balancing is 17,000. Okay. After that, we'll just add back the abnormal items. Why? Because this profit has been has come after deducting these items, these loss or gain. But this abnormal loss and abnormal gain should not be deducted from the post. Okay, so first we need to reverse the effect. So how we have come to this profit, we have seen in profit and loss account, we derive the profit by adding all the gains and deducting all the losses. So we'll just reverse this effect. Now here we'll add all the losses and deduct all the gains so that we come to the correct profit. 17,000, 15,000 were our loss, so we'll add back. 3,000 was our gain, so we'll just deduct it. We have come to the now the normal profits of 29,000. After that, we'll do the time adjustments, because investment was done on 1st July 2017, so 3 months profit belonged to the pre period. 17,000, the difference profit, it's of the full year. Okay, it is evenly distributed, but 3 months belong to the pre, so we'll just deduct 3 months profit from here and we'll add in the pre profit. So how we'll do this? 29,000 into 3 divided by 12 minus 7250 will be done from here, and 7250 will be added in the pre profits. Okay, after that, do the adjustments. Like abnormal gain belongs to the pre period, as we have seen, abnormal gain, because investment was done afterwards and abnormal gain belonged to the pre period, so gain will be added in the pre profits and loss will be deducted from the post profits because it is after investment. So gain was of 3000, so it will be added in the pre, and abnormal loss, so now it will be deducted, so it will be deducted from the post. We have come to the net profit and loss account. Okay, now the holding company share was 80%, so we'll just bifurcate into holding and minority. Holding 80%, minority 20%, so 33250 into 0.8 and 33250 into 0.2 minority share. Okay, and similarly here 6750 into 0.8 equal to 6750 into 0.2. Sorry. Okay. After that, I have got here the pre-profits and the post-profits. 33250 and 6750. We'll just write here pre-acquisition profits and post-acquisition profit. Why we have bifurcated here? So, because the exchange rate for converting the pre-profit is the opening rate, and we have used the exchange rate for converting the post-profit is average exchange rate. Okay, so after that we'll just write down the exchange rates given here. How you will write that exchange rates? Current all assets and liabilities are converted at the closing rate, so closing rate is 42. We have just written all the assets and liabilities as exchange rate as 42. Share capital, that is equity side, it was converted using the opening rate, that is 30. It is given 30. Share capital will be converted using exchange rate of 30. Pre-acquisition will be converted using exchange rate of 30. But post-acquisition profit, we'll convert this using the average exchange rate. So average exchange rate is 36. Just how we'll do this? 30,000 into 30. Similarly, all will be 6750 into 36. 20,000 into 42 will come to 840,000. 10,000 into 42, 420,000. 20,000 into 42, 840,000. Okay. Similarly, in the asset side, so total will come of the asset side 450,40,000, but liability side will not come this, so there will be some balancing figure, that is 799,500 is a balancing figure we'll derive after conversion. Due to the conversion rates, we derive some balance, that is a gain or loss. We'll write it as foreign currency translation reserve. Okay, now next step is calculate goodwill, minority interest and consolidated P&L as we do in our consolidation. While calculating the COC, we know what we used to do while calculating the goodwill or minority interest, goodwill or capital reserve, investment less net assets, what the investment I have done and how much I have received. So investment less net assets, so investment amount is 16 lakh. We can see from balance sheet investment is 16 lakh. Net assets will be seen from the equity way, that is less share capital and pre-profits. Share capital is, now we'll see this balance sheet, converted balance sheet. Share capital is 9 lakh. So less share capital. Our share was 80%. So 7,20,000. Similarly, we'll deduct the pre-profits. How we'll do? Our share was 26,600 into exchange rate is 30. 798,000. I'll get the FCTR, foreign currency translation reserve, though it's a part of OCI. It do not comes in profit and loss account, but we'll deduct it from here. That is 799,500. That is our balancing figure, 799,500. After that, after doing these adjustments, we have come up to capital reserve. Capital reserve comes in the balance sheet, reserves and surplus. Capital reserve 717,500, working note number 2. You can refer that. After that, we'll calculate the minority interest, working note number 3. Okay, how we calculate? Share capital was of 9 lakh. 9 lakh into minority share was 20%. 180,000. We'll just add the post profits, pre and post profits of minority. See, P and post profit 6650 into 30 exchange rate. Similarly, post profits 1350 into 36. So minority interest 428100. 428100 is our minority interest. After that, we'll calculate the consolidated P&L. Okay, consolidated profit and loss account. Profit and loss of holding company was given of 20 lakh. We'll just take that amount, consolidated P&L 20 lakh. We'll add the post profits of holding, that is 5400. See, 5400 into exchange rate was 36. So 194400. So 219400 is our consolidated P&L, which will come here, consolidated P&L. Now we'll do the consolidation as it is. Okay, share capital of X Limited, we'll take that. We'll ignore the share capital of our subsidiary company. We just see this and this converted balance sheet. Okay, after that, I have already calculated the consolidated P&L, capital reserve and minority interest from the working notes. Now the loan amount, we'll see how we'll, now we'll just add back this 840,000. $10 lakh of holding, $840,000 of subsidiary. Total of the liability side comes to 1,12,40,000. Similarly, in asset side, we'll just combine all the both the fixed assets and current assets of both the companies, like this plus 840,000. Similarly, in all the current assets, will do the same. Total of the asset side is 1,12,40,000. So this is the way how we consolidate our foreign subsidiary. Thank you so much.